Hi everyone, I'm Cody at W3AMG with Bridgecom Systems, and today we're going to be showing you how to create an analog code plug for your Anytone radio. Awesome, here we go. So we have our radio fully factory reset, so this is just like you would get your radio. So first, we're going to plug our programming cable into the computer, just like that. Make sure you have your software downloaded. If not, we have some videos that will show you how. And we will plug in our programming cable just like that. There you go. Make sure your radio is turned on. Now, let's jump over here to the computer. First thing we're going to do is just check the COM port. Click that button up there between the read button and the write button. There we go, COM3. Now, if you have multiple COM ports showing up, what you can do, well, you have this menu open, just go ahead and unplug the radio. You'll see one drop off, plug it back in, one will show up, and then you can go ahead and select the right one. Now click the read from radio button right up here. And in this case, I already had something open, so we won't save it. Click OK, and then just read the other data. Now, if you don't do this, things can get a little bit funny. You want to make sure you do that. What can happen if you don't is you'll end up getting a band error down the road after you put in a lot of work on your code plug, and you don't want that. There we go, we're in good shape here. Read data complete. If we're just doing an analog channel, we need some information because we need to know what we're putting in it. So go over to a web browser, go to repeaterbook.com. Now this is a great resource for finding repeaters. If you already know what you're putting in the radio, you can skip ahead, but this is the best way to find some of that information. So we can go to North American repeaters. There we go, once you're here, just go ahead and select your region or your state. There we go, we'll scroll down here. Now if you know what you're looking for, you can filter based on what kind of repeater you're looking for. If you want the DMR or a specific band, in this case, we could just choose all. Now, my personal favorite way to find these is on a map. So if you click map results, and then in this case, Google Maps, this is actually going to put all of those repeaters on a map. There we go. So we can go ahead and find our area. Here we go. We'll zoom in here. Here we go. So here's the general area. Let's see, is this an analog repeater? So you can just click on one and then click more, and that will open up the page that explains everything about it. Let's see, this is analog, perfect. So this will be a good option for us. Might be a little bit far to hit. We may be able to hit it if we have a good antenna. Let's see here. So downlink, uplink, the best way to think about these frequencies. So your repeater is traditionally up high on a tower, right? So repeaters are generally almost always up high. And radios, on the other hand, are typically on the ground with us. So if you think about it in the eyes of the radio, downlink, that's going to be receiving from the repeater. Now uplink, on the other hand, that's going to be transmitting up to the repeater. So just go ahead and write those down. Now for an analog repeater, you will also want to write down the tones. Now it may not have any tones, or it might. This is a privacy tone. Your radio will actually encode or decode this tone to make the reception audible. So in this case, we have an uplink tone of 127.3. There we go. It doesn't look like we have a downlink tone. So go ahead and record that information. Now let's go over here to our software. There we go. So once we are here, go ahead and just create yourself a new channel. You can delete what comes in the radio if you like, or you can leave it there. It doesn't make a difference. And let's give it a name. So there we go. Now our receive frequency. Again, receive, that was going to be the downlink. So let's see, our receive was 443.9. We'll put that in here. There we go. Now, what about our transmit? We'll go back out here. The uplink was 448.9. There you go. So 448.9. Now we're going to switch this over to analog and go ahead and set your power. In this case, it's a little bit far, so we're going to set turbo, have the best chance of hitting it. Bandwidth in this case is going to be 25K for an analog ham system. We can leave a lot of this stuff off. This is for APRS. Now go down here. Here's your tones, your CTCSS and DCS. Encode and decode. So let's go see what it's looking for. We're looking for an uplink tone. So uplink, again, is transmit. So that means we are wanting to encode the tone. Decode will be, you know, determining it, like deciphering it. Encode is going to be putting that tone on the transmission, if you want to think about it that way. So that's going to be on the transmit. So there we go, encode. Here we go, CTCSS, and go ahead and select the tone, 127.3. There you go, select that. We can leave the other one off. Just go ahead and hit OK. It's that simple. Our channel is ready to use, but not quite. We have to do a couple more things to actually make it work on the radio. So go ahead and go over to Zone. You'll want to either use the zone that's here or create yourself a new one. In this case, I'm just going to get rid of the original one. We don't need it. We'll take everything out of it. Oops. And let's go ahead and put our new channel in it. Here you go. We could write this to radio. It would work. But let's do a little bit more customization to make our radio our own. So go to optional settings. And what you definitely want to do is go to work mode and change this display mode from frequency to channel. This will actually allow you to see the channel you created instead of just having a frequency. After that, I like to go to power on and change a couple things here. How about changing our custom characters? So when you turn the radio on, you can actually have a custom boot image. In this case, we just have some lettering, so we can change that to customize it. So I could put my name and call sign in here. Just like that. There we go, cool. Now, one more thing I like to customize, go to display and change your standby BK picture to custom one. We'll go ahead and click OK. This will allow us to have a custom background picture. This is really cool. Now, go over here to tool up at the top, click on tool, and then go to standby BK picture one. Once you're there, we already have an image, but if yours probably will not come selected. So just click open image. And what you'll do is just go find your CPS, so the download of CPS that you had, click on it, and it will have come with this screens folder. Click on it, and from here you can select any of the screens you like. So we'll pick one. There you go, that looks good. Click open. Once you've done that, just go ahead and hit write, then okay. And it's going to write that screen to the radio. Now, nothing is really going to happen on your radio yet. We still have to actually write the rest of the code plug over. So from here, just click on your COM port settings. We'll wait for that radio to show back up once it reboots. There you go. So we're set there. Go ahead and click OK. And at this point, you can just click write to radio, click OK, and then write the other data. There we go, it's complete. So we'll give it a second and unplug that programming cable. There we go, we can go ahead and unplug that cable. There we go, check it out. So we have our new startup screen. Now you could make this an image if you'd like. In this case, we've just got our name and call sign, and there we go. We have our zone, and we have that really cool background. This totally changes your radio. It makes it look 1,000 times cooler. So definitely worthwhile doing. There we go. So we have that set up. Now we have our local repeater in our zone that we can see, and we are ready to make our first QSO.